my fellow farmers, it's me, your favorite farmer girl Vladda. And today I'm doing... You've been waiting for it. Oh, you so have been waiting for it. Yes, it's true. Today I am doing the most epic farming tutorial, part 3. In this tutorial, we'll look at the Kingdom versus Kingdom game mode. So, how do you plan to win KVK? It's easy. You gotta outfarm them. Big time. So let's answer two very important questions. What resources should I gather to earn the most points? And which troops should I send to those nodes? Choosing the right node during KVK is not a simple task, since you earn different amount of points for the different resources. You get points for every 1,000 gathered units of a resource. In particular, you earn 240 points for grain, 360 points for wood or stone, 480 points for iron, and 660 points for gold. So you'd say it's a good idea to gather gold, right? Wrong. Oh, and the reason why I'm doing this tutorial and not you is because you just totally fell for that trick question. So let me explain why gold isn't the best resource to gather in KVK. So let us take a look at the points you earned for the different kind of nodes. Grain nodes contain, depending on the level, between 225,000 and 4,125,000 units. And you'll earn between 54,000 and 990,000 points for emptying it. Wood and stone nodes are equal in the amount of resources they contain. A level 1 node contains 180,000 units, while a level 5 node contains 3,300,300 units. And they'll earn you between 64,800 and 1,188,000 points. Iron nodes contain between 135,000 and 2,475,000 units and earn you between 64,800 and 1,188,000 points per node, just as wood and stone nodes do. Gold node contains between 67,500 and 1,462,500 units, and you earn between 44,660 and 965,250 points for emptying them. Looking at the point value, we can conclude that it is best to farm either node containing iron, wood or stone, while gold nodes or grain nodes aren't as good, right? Wrong again. Do you fall for every trick question? To come to a conclusion, we need to take a look at the amount of time it takes to empty a node. The node that gets emptied the fastest is the iron node. Emptying a gold node takes 7% more time than emptying an iron node. emptying a grain note is 11% slower than emptying an iron note. And emptying a wood or stone note is a whole 33% slower than emptying an iron note. If we take it into the consideration, we'll end up with the following ranking. At the last place, we get the grain note. Wood and stone notes are sharing the third place. The gold note comes in second, and the iron note is a long champion. Oh, and you should have totally come to this conclusion without any math done. I mean, honestly, they all are fighting for the iron throne, not the golden one. Really, how didn't you notice that? But let's compare the numbers. We figured that you will get 1,188,000 points for emptying a level 5 iron note. We will take the time you need to emptying a level 5 iron note as a basic calculation time and see what points you will get if you spend this time on another note. So, if you go to a level 5 gold note, you will earn in the same time only 902,000 points. Stone and wood will bring you only 893,000 points, and grain only 891,000 points. Well, as you can see, the iron note is the most epic note during the KVK. Let us take a look at what troops you should send out together. There are differences between troop types and troop tiers, and only two stats are farming relevant: troop speed and carrying capacity. Cavalry units are the fastest, but can carry the smallest amount of resources, while bowmen are really slow, but carry a lot. Don't forget, the enemy kingdom will get points for eliminating troops. Sending less troops is equal to losing less points when they get attacked. Capacity is an important feature here. Who would have thought? The bowman rule! But what tier do we send? Let's check the numbers. To empty a level 5 iron note, you will need 309,375 D1 bowmen or 247,500 T2 bowmen or 165,000 T3 bowmen or 82,500 T4 bowmen. The value of these troops in elimination points would be 309,375 points for tier 1, 495,000 points for tier 2, 990,000 points for tier 3, and 1,485,000 points for tier 4. So, using T1 bowmen is the best thing to do. Please note, all these numbers are without the equipment or any other bonus. You may gather faster and with less troops, but T1 bowmen on the iron note is still the magic trick. And you know why? Well, because I, the most favorite farming girl Vladda, said so. In this most epic farming tutorial, part 3. And I know it, you know it, well, everybody knows that you are totally waiting for the most epic farming tutorial, part 4. Oh well, see you then.